And today our topic is governor. Now we are going to discussing about classifications of governor. First of all, we have to know about the meaning of governor. What is governor? Governor is a mechanical device which is used to regulate the mean speed of the engine when there are variations in the load, and that is the meaning of a governor. And let us see the classifications of governor. The governor is broadly classified into mainly two types. And first one is inertia governor, and second one is centrifugal governor. First one is inertia governor, second one centrifugal governor. And here they are not used inertia governor, because inertia governor is a huge type of use weight of governor, we can say use of mass of governor. And centrifugal governor preferred governor because it is a light in weight. And centrifugal governor again classified into two types. And one is pendulum type, second one is loaded type governor. The pendulum type governor is what governor? And loaded type governor, here we have two types of governors: dead weight governor and spring loaded governor. Centrifugal governor, here we have two type of governors: pendulum type governor and loaded governor. Pendulum type governor, it has the what governor, and loaded governor again it classified into two types. One is dead weight governor and second one is spring loaded governor. And dead weight governor, again it have classified into two types: Porter governor and Proel governor. And next one, spring loaded governor, it is also classified into four types: the Hartnell governor, and next one Harton governor, and next one Wilson Hartnell governor, and finally Pickering governor. And this is about a brief explanation of governors. And let us see in pendulum type governor the derivation part of what governor, and see the diagram. And it is the diagram of what governor. What governor is recommended for the centrifugal governor, and centrifugal governor is recommended for the loaded governor. And here we see, and this is the spindle. and these are balls, gas balls, and it is sleeve. Here the spindle is connected to the directly the engine shaft. The spindle, when the engine is rotated, the connection of the spindle part is also rotated, which will be rotating. Here, when the speed is increased, the sleeve is moving upward. Here, the connection of mechanism in between the sleeve and a portion of the base of governor, and it is nothing but bell crank lever. And already we discussed about the meaning of governor. It regulates the mean speed of the governor. Here the fuel supply is passed to the engine, and it is bell crank lever. When the speed is increased, engine speed is increased, the weight of the engine is decreased. At that time, the sleeve is moving upward and it operates the, touches the bell crank lever, and the bell crank lever is closed, and fuel supply is also stopped. When the speed is decreased, the engine speed is decreased, the weight of the engine is increased. At that time, the bell crank lever, it tries to in vertical position like this, and the fuel supply is increased. When the speed is increased, the balls moves outward. The balls are moves outward. At that time, smaller radius of the ball, and from center of the spindle to the ball distance, and it is indicating small range. When the speed is increased, the balls are moving outward, radius will be increased, then the X is decreased. When the speed is decreased, radius is decreased, then height is increased. Here, the outward force, F is centrifugal force, it is called centrifugal force, F equal to MR omega square. Here the force is acting downward, mg, and this is the small ball mass. And here we see, when the sleeve is moving upward and downward, it touches the links. These are lower link, and this one is the upper link. And here the tension will be formed when the sleeve is moving on upward and downward. And this is the tension T1, and this is the tension T2. Okay, and see the derivative part of the watt governor. The tension T, and from the angle this is theta, and here also the opposite angle theta. T1 is equal to cos theta, and T2 sin theta, and Fc equal to nothing but MR omega square. Fc equal to nothing but MR omega square. MR omega square equal to T cos theta, Mg equal to T sin theta, and this is equation 1 and this is equation. And equation 2 by equation 1 T sin theta by T cos theta, and equation 1 by equation 2. Therefore, T sin theta by
t cos theta equal to mr omega square by n, and cancel the similar remains, and here l and m. Finally, sin theta by cos theta equal to r omega square by g, tan theta equal to r omega square by g. Here the tan theta is h, and h by r equal to omega square by g.
Let's see here, and this point is A, and this point is B, and this point is C. And finally we got the value h equal to 895 by n square, and this is the height of the girdle. In next class we will continue the water girdle. Thank you.